I hope you all are doing great. So today I am here to continue with the same chapter which we have discussed in our previous video, chapter number 5, the value of time. So all of you please open your value education books, page number 28. So today we are going to read the story which is given in your book, page number 28, the two brothers. Earlier we have discussed how to value time, because time is very important, it is very precious and we need to respect time. We need to give respect time and we need to learn that time is very essential for us and time is very important part in our life and we need to respect time. So today we are going to read the story. It is a very good story which is given on page number 28. So I'll be reading and explaining, so please follow me carefully. So yes, here I go. David and John were brothers. David was a hard-working and responsible child, while John was irresponsible and careless. Their exams were approaching. One day, John said to David, "I'm going to play football. Why don't you join me?" David thought for a while and said, "No, I have to study some important lessons. Sorry, I cannot join you." Leaving David behind, John went to play. So in this paragraph, it is given that this is a story about two boys whose names were David and John. So David was a hardworking one. Hardworking means he was very sincere towards his studies, towards his work. So he was a very good student and a good boy, obedient boy. Whereas John was an irresponsible one. Either he was concentrating on his studies and even he was careless towards his studies, and even he was indisciplined and irresponsible. He was not at all responsible person. So David was the responsible one and John was the irresponsible one. He is not concentrating on his studies and neither concentrating on his work. So their exams were approaching. Approaching means the exams were coming. Now the exams were coming. The two boys were brothers and the exams were coming. So John asked David, John said to David that I am going to play football. You can imagine the exams were coming. John was the responsible one. He was the sincere one. And David was the responsible one. David was the sincere one. And John was asking David to play football while the exams were coming. So you see how irresponsible kind of a boy he was. So David replied, "No, I will not play football. I have to study for my exams. I have to study some important lessons." So like that, he refused John. Whereas John did not want to study, so he went out to play football and he did not listen to even David. He could at least gain some sincerity from David, his brother, who was very sincere. He wanted to study and he wanted to play. So they were different from each other. So John went out to play football. So now we'll see what happens in the next paragraph. After a few days, John again asked David, "I am going to fly a kite. You love flying kites. Come with me." David again thought for a while and said, "I want to join, but I have to start revision. That is more important. So I cannot join you," he added. "John, our exams are very near, so you should concentrate on your studies." John just laughed at David and went away. David started studying. Now, firstly, he went to play football. Now, the second time again, John asked David to fly kites. So, you see, John is so irresponsible. He still don't want to study. His exams are so near. He asked his brother, David, David, come on, we fly kites. So, David loved to fly kites, you know. But he refused. He said, "No, brother, you should study. Your exams are coming. Our exams are coming. And I have to do revision. So why are you wasting time? You should study." But John did not listen to David. He made fun of him. And he said, "Oh, please come on, stop it. I'm going to fly kites." And he again went away. So you see how irresponsible kind of a guy he is. He is so disobedient. Actually, he's not even obedient to his brother. His brother was explaining him, but he did not listen to his brother even. And he went away to fly kites. And then David was doing revision. David was studying, but he was not studying. He was playing. He was not at all serious towards his studies. So now we'll see what happens in the last paragraph. Days passed. Both John and David appeared for their exams. When the results were declared, David came second in class, while John failed. John became very upset and started crying. David went to him and said, "We have a limited amount of time. We should apply it on more important things. You wasted time in playing games and never realized that studies are more important. That is why you are repenting. Change your attitude, have self-control, and learn to respect time." John realized his mistake and decided to change himself. So now, after a few days, means some days have been passed, and after a few days, both John and David appeared for the exams. Appeared means now it's time for the exams. So they went to write the exams, write the papers. So what happened after a few days when the exams got over and results had been declared? So what was the result? You see, David, his brother, came second in class. Yes, he came second in class, whereas John failed. Yes, John failed. And with the result, John got very upset. He got very upset and he got very disheartened, very sad. So his brother explained him. His brother David went to John and he explained him that, "John, you see, you did not respect time. Rather, you wasted time. And this is your punishment to which you are repenting." Repenting means regretting. Because now John was regretting about his actions. He was regretting that why he had wasted so much time. He could have studied. He could have done his revision. He could have studied some subjects. He could have studied in a better way. He could have listened to his brother, but he did not do so. To a result, what happened? He failed. And now he is regretting. So now what is the use to regret? Right? Now time has been passed. Time waits for none. I have already told you in the previous video that time and times are wait for none. Time, once it's gone forever. So when there was a time, he did not study, rather he played. And now when time has got over, when it was the final day, he was studying just one day before exam. So how will he get passed? So he failed and then he realized his mistakes, that he wasted time. If he would have studied, he would have scored good marks like his brother. Because his brother did not waste time, his brother respected time, and as a result, what happened? His brother secured second position in class. And what happened to John? He failed. So yes, this was the moral of the story, that you should not waste time. Never waste time. Please never waste time. Learn to respect time. Because if you will waste time, same thing will happen to you. Like John, what he did, what happened to John? John repented. John regretted later that what he did was bad, what was actually worse, because he wasted his time. So he failed in his exams. So if you people will also waste time, you will also regret like John. So don't be like John, be like David. Always respect time. Be sincere towards your work. Be sincere towards your studies. And be hardworking. Do not waste time. Just learn to respect time. If you want to play, play for 1 hour. But study also. Play. If you want to play, play. If you want to but you need to study together. So I'm not asking you to only study. I'm just asking you to even play and even study, but should manage time properly. It's not like that you play the whole day, the entire day you're just playing, you're not even studying for exams. So it is bad, it is wrong. Play for 1 hour and then study for 3 or 4 hours. That is better. Manage time accordingly. But don't waste time like John. Otherwise, you can also fail in your exams. So yes, this was the story. I hope you all have understood the story. And I hope you all have learned something from the story. So don't be like John. Be like David. Be a good student. Don't waste time. And respect time. And these are some golden words given, which we have already discussed in our previous video. These golden words and these ponder and practice, I've already explained you about these golden words and ponder and practice. So learn these two carefully. Just watch it carefully and then learn it properly. So yes, that's all for today. So thank you and take care.